Hi viewer, I welcome you to the Rim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through geography from one lesson number 18. The topic it is statistical methods. I'm your tutor, Rosie Muthon. Welcome. We are going to look at the lesson goals. That is what you are going to look at. By the end of the lesson, the learner should be able to identify methods of recording the data and then analyze the data. Let us start by looking at different methods that we used for the recording of the data. Now, this involves the recording of figures and facts collected in the field to ensure that all details are available for analysis. So you record all the information that you have collected. There are different ways we can use to record the data. One of the ways, it is the tabulation. When we talk about the tabulation, this is recording of data by arranging the facts of figures in form of a table or a list. For example, we have that image. The table below is the temperature of Mwanza measured and recorded on our table. You can see the month and the temperature. They are given there. That is recording in a table, which we are referring to it as the tabulation. The next method, it is the photography. This is the capturing what is observed in the field and storing it in form of a photograph. This is done by use of the camera to record geographical information. Next, it is the note-taking. This involves the making of short notes during an interview so that no information given is lost. Number four, it is labeling of samples. Once the samples are collected in the field, they should be put in a polythene box and clearly labeled by naming them. For example, when you are going to the field collecting the data of rocks, you collect those different types of the rocks. You can put them in a polythene bag, label them, or different types of the soils. You collect them, come with them, put them in a polythene bag, then you label them. Number five, it is the filling in of the questionnaires. The data is recorded by filling in the information as instructed in the questionnaire. Then we have the mapping. It's another method that we can apply. This involves the drawing of the sketch map to show the distribution of various items in an area. You just draw that sketch map. Then we have the field sketching. This involves the preparation of a simple sketch of what is observed in the field. And the other one, it is the tape recording, which is done when one is collecting data through an oral interview, when one uses tape recording device to record the conversation. The next one, we have the tally. This is used when the data is collected through the counting. One counts and puts the tally. We have the one counting and putting the tally. Then we putting one count and put a vertical strike for every item counted. On the fifth count, one puts a diagonal crossing for the four strokes. For example, you have the matter to that passed in a certain road at 4 p.m. You can get them there. Buses, cars, motorcycle, you can get them there by use of tally. You can see they were 14. Then for the buses, they were 12. For the cars, they were 20. For the motorcycle, they were 15. The next one, it is data analysis. How do we analyze the data? Statistical analysis means examining the recorded figures and facts in details so as to explain the meaning and the feature of the data. The main methods of data analysis. One, it is calculation of the percentages. Number two, it is measure of the central tendencies. Number three, it is the measure of the dispersion. This is what I want us to look at. We start by calculation of percentages. The data collected may be converted into percentages in order to make it meaningful. For example, in the study of a farm, 20 hectares were devoted to that, and the total acres were 100 hectares. Find the percentage under 10. So it is 20 divided by 100, the total times 100, which is the 20%. We take the next. Measurement of the central tendencies. The central tendency is the outstanding general characteristics of the data. The main measures of the central tendency are the mean, the median, the mode. Those are the main measures of the central tendency. Let us look at them, how they are calculated. For the mean, it is the also referred to as the arithmetic mean. It is obtained by dividing the sum of the number of all values with the number of observations made. An example, the population density for 5 sublocations are 10, 11, 14, 20, and 20 persons per kilometer square. Then find the mean. So we happen to take 10, 11, 14, and 20, and 20, but we don't divide by 2 like the IT is. We divide by 5 outcomes. So you get it is 15 persons. So the formula becomes mean is equal to the summation of x divided by n. N it is the number of observations. X bar it is the mean. Summation of x, it is the sum of the individual values observed. We take the next one, that is the median. This is the mean real value given set of data arranged in a rank. To obtain the median, all values are arranged in ascending or descending order. Then the mean real value is determined. For example, you have the data solution we arrange it, and then the mean real value is 12. That is the way we get it. When the set is even number, we simply add the two mean real values and divide by 2. To get the median. Then we go to the mode. Mode is the most frequent recurring value in a set of data. For example, we have 4, 5, 7, 9, 5, 2, 8, 4, 9, 5, 1, 5. If I tell you look at 5, it is repeating many times, 4 times, than the other numbers. So it becomes the mode of the data. Then we go to the last one, which is the measure of dispersion. Measure of dispersion show how the data provided is spread out. The main measure of dispersion is the range. The higher the range, the more dispersed the data is. And the lower the range, the less dispersed the data is. The range is obtained from subtracting the higher value from the lower value. Formula, it is that XL, which is the highest value, minus the XS, which is the smallest value, for the lowest value. So in that case, we get the value. Activity. State three ways in which we can analyze the data by means of central tendency. And number two, identify three ways in which we can analyze the statistical data. You can visit the KRB 2003 Secondary Geography Student Book 1. That edition for more information. And also, if at all you feel like contacting us, you can get us through the SMS. You can SMS the number. You can also get us through the YouTube. You can also get us from the Facebook. You can also get us from the Twitter. You can Twitter us through that. Stay tuned to Edin TV. Thank you.